Thank you, London, very much indeed. Welcome to the Odeon in Birmingham. This is one terrific event. There are 3,000 people packed in here to see live on this stage, Depeche. We'll be right back. Everything Counts from Depeche Mode. So that's just a taste of the band. More from them a bit later on. Also a taste of the atmosphere here at the Birmingham Odeon. Have you ever thought what goes into a gig like this? The behind the scenes, the tickets, the merchandising, and the transport. Here's an insight.
Peter Powell, it's Radio 1.
Just a few moments to let you know about a special event which is happening on February the 3rd. If you remember last year, between September and October, Depeche Mode did a concert tour of Britain, but they only had the chance to do one date in Birmingham, and they want to go back there again. It was a sellout last time, so if you want to get there and see the concert, I suggest you do yourselves a favour and get down to the box office.
What do you like about Depeche Mode?
The music, firstly, and secondly, they're really nice young men.
How will you be behaving while they're on stage?
Well, I'm quite a rational, level-headed sort of person, but I expect I'll jump up and down a bit.
We usually leave the hotel about 11 o'clock and arrive at the sound check about 4 o'clock. So we just take it easy, we don't rush.
Watch a film
and play some music, have a laugh.
We don't do that, we never have a laugh.
Well, when we're touring, what normally happens is we start off by having a meeting with our agent, Dan Silver, and just decide where and when we're going to tour.
Morning, Dan, it's John. Just looking through this proposed running order of Neil's for the Oxford Roadshow.
And then we leave it up to him to come up with an itinerary of dates.
I think we're going to have to put the equipment in and rig it all night. That's the only way that I can see around it.
John?
Yeah?
How much does it cost in altogether, then? On budget, sort of thing.
Well, the budget's about £85,000 for the tour. And we should... I mean, that's as it stands flat without anything extra on the top. Most of the people are getting about £200 a week plus PDs. All right, like the sort of skilled people.
No.
Like sort of operators and things like that. I buy that monster good time. Love's not enough in itself.
It's very important to have a luxury coach like this because a lot of the journeys are quite long and it gets pretty tiring when you're on the road. So if we were travelling in a minibus, we wouldn't feel very much like playing when we got to the gig.
Okay, Depeche in England, we've got sandwiches for breakfast, actually cooked breakfast things.
We actually have two young ladies that come on the road with us, and they cook us a three-course meal every day.
Very nice.
Very nice.
What's the dessert?
I've a tendency to be unhappy. You see the thoughts in my head.
Well, as per your instructions.
I got together with Bravado. And we just talked about it a few times, had a few meetings, then I've come up with some rough sketches, ideas for T-shirts and things.
I think it's important to keep the hang running right the way through.
Yeah, well, we've used people that buy the stuff know that they've actually got official merchandise, and it's good quality stuff. Well, mainly the thing that I think would probably annoy most bands about the merchandisers that come outside gigs and sell all their gear is that most of the gear is just a load of old crap. The photographs are usually just bootleg photographs that maybe they've picked up out of a magazine and they try and draw it, on a T-shirt. And the kids that will buy the things outside because that's the first thing they see. They're not to know that those people aren't actually selling good gear. Don't buy it.
Excuse me, we're from the BBC. Can you tell me where you...
Boys meet boys, get together. Boys meet boys, it's forever. Don't say no, boys say go, go, go.
We've got this tradition when we, you know, me and Martin drink a bottle of wine between us. We do a downer as we actually go into the dressing room, which is a whole glass in straight down.
Right, Dale.
Sore throat, bad karma, man.
That's just a glimpse of behind the scenes. This is a glimpse of behind the scenes backstage for this live gig with Depeche Mode. I don't know if you can hear what I'm saying, I can't hear myself think, but what I have got to do is introduce your band on a video showcase tonight called Adventure. They're a nine-piece, they come from Manchester. They've been together for just 1 year, and it's a track called I Need the Light.
This is the inner sanctum of BBC on the road for a pop gig like tonight. There's so many things going on out there, with 3,000 people packed in. What about lighting a big event like Depeche Mode? We've got a film for you now, just to see all the complicated things that go into lighting such a very big gig as this.
It's very hard work. There's no glamour to it. It's dirty and it's hard work. The whole thing's a very pretty rig. It's very complicated to set up because it is very intricate. And you get very slick at it after a while. You're doing it every day, getting in at 10 in the morning, getting out at 1 in the morning. I mean, as time goes on, it gets shorter and shorter.
Construction time again. What is it this time? We're laying a pipeline. Let the beads of sweat flow till the ends of that glow. Could take a long time. Working on the pipeline.
I started in the lighting business about 5 years ago, actually being a designer 3 years, but the first 2 years doing apprenticeship with lifting boxes and working for different companies, that sort of thing. Depeche Mode suited me particularly because I like something quite subtle. I see a lot of mood changes, got a lot of light and depth, all that sort of thing.
I wonder if you've got any ideas about the pressure pads, because last time we had those few problems with them, I don't know if Dave was happy with them.
Yeah, I'm not sure whether the positioning of them was quite right for Dave, because he felt a bit uncomfortable with them last time.
The original idea is to have separate pads all over the stage, which Dave would step between, and a light would hit him wherever he was. But he's so excitable on stage, he's running around, and he just misses them. So we tried putting them in one bunch, and he'd jump over them. So we're having a bit of problems with those. We think we're going to have it sorted out for this tour.
Towers over here were changing around because the Venetians didn't seem to work very well. We're going to try having the slats the other way up and try and get more shafts of light coming through those.
Yeah. So we'll definitely have some stuff behind those slats.
Oh, yeah, we'll try and get a really
well.
Nice sort of coal mine look about it.
Yeah.
Lots of furnace-y atmosphere.
Yeah. what I have seen of the lights, I've been very impressed with them. It's been really good.
And that's James Spears. We're now back live, Depeche Mode on stage. Four more numbers coming back. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. And this one is called Shame.
Thank you. Bring me my gun, a bitch in desire. Bring me my gun.
Enjoy the second part of the Depeche Mode concert here in Birmingham live. Unfortunately, our camera's got to leave very soon. We'll be back in the studio in Manchester next week. We'll look forward to seeing you there. But now Depeche Mode are back on for Just Can't Get Enough.
Thank you. I gotta see you, man! Just like